శుక్లాంబరధరం విష్ణుం శశివర్ణం చతుర్భుజం ప్రసన్నవదనం ధ్యాయేత్ సర్వ విఘ్నోపశాంతయే. సుందరకాండ ఇట్ సెల్ఫ్ రిక్వైర్స్ స్పెషల్ అటెన్షన్, సో వీల్ డీల్ విత్ సుందరకాండ. బిఫోర్ దట్ ది యూజువల్ ప్రేయర్స్ దట్ వీ డూ వెన్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు డీల్ విత్ రామాయణ, వీ విల్ డూ దోస్ అండ్ దెన్ గెట్ ఇన్ టు సుందరకాండ. ఆపదామపహర్తారం దాతారం సర్వసంపదాం లోకాభిరామం శ్రీరామం భూయో భూయో నమామ్యహం. శుక్లాంబరధరం విష్ణుం శశివర్ణం చతుర్భుజం ప్రసన్నవదనం ధ్యాయేత్ సర్వ విఘ్నోపశాంతయే. యశ్చ ద్విరదవక్త్రాద్యాః పారిషద్యాః పరశ్చతం విఘ్నన్ నిఘ్నంతి సతతం విక్షక్సేనం తమాశ్రయే. జ్ఞానానందమయం దేవం నిర్మలస్ఫటికాకృతిమాధారం సర్వవిద్యానాం హయగ్రీవముపాస్మహే. కుజంతన్ రామ రామేతి మధురం మధురక్షరం ఆహూయ కవితాశాఖాం వందే వాల్మీకి కోకిలం. గోష్పదీకృతవారాశిం మషికీకృతరాక్షసం రామాయణ మహామాలారత్నం వందే అనిలాత్మజం. అంజనానందనం వీరం జానకీశోకనాశనం కపీచమక్షాంతారం వందే లంకాభయంకరం. మనోజవం మరుతతుల్యవేగం జితేంద్రియం బుద్ధిమతాం వరిష్టం వాతాత్మజం వానరయుధముఖ్యం శ్రీరామదూతం శిరసా నమామి. వేదవేద్యే పరే పుంసి జాతే దశరథాత్మజే వేద ప్రాచేత్ సాదాసీత్ సాక్షాత్ రామాయణాత్మన చరితం రఘునాథస్య శతకోటి పరవిస్తరమేకైకమక్షరం ప్రోక్తం మహాపాతకనాశనం. వాల్మీకిగిరి సంభూత రామసాగరగామిని పునాతి భువనం పుణ్యారామాయణ మహానది. యక్కర్ణాంజలి సంపుటై అహరహ సమ్యక్ పిబత్యాదరాత్ వాల్మీకేర్వదనారవిందగళితం రామాయణఖ్యం మధు. జన్మవ్యాధిజరా విపత్తిమరణై అత్యంత సోపద్రవం సంసారం సవిహాయ గచ్చతి పుమాన్ విష్ణోపదం శాశ్వతం. శ్రీరాఘవం దశరథాత్మజం అప్రమేయం సీతాపతిం రఘుకులాన్వయరత్నదీపమాజానుబాహుమరవిందదలాయదక్షం రమం నిచాచర వినాశకరం నమామి. వైదేహీ సైతం సరుద్రమతలే హైమే మహామంటపే మధ్యే పుష్పకమాసనే మణిమయే వీరాసనే సంస్థితం అగ్రే వాచేతి ప్రభంజనసుతే తత్వం మునిభ్యః పరం వ్యాఖ్యాతం భరతాదిభిపరివృతం రామం భజే శ్యామలం. ఆపదామభర్తారం దాతారం సర్వసంపదాం లోకాభిరామం శ్రీరామం భూయో భూయో నమామ్యహం. శ్రీరఘునందన పరబ్రహ్మణే నమః. ఎట్ ది ఎండ్ ఆఫ్ ది కిష్కింద కాండ వి ఫైండ్ monkeys, prominent among them, were sent in different directions, and Hanuma, Jambavan, Angada, these people have gone towards south. And Jambavan was telling Hanuma about the greatness of Hanuma. Hanuma requires to be told about his greatness. Some people don't need to be told about their greatness, they enjoy their greatness. Hanuma is not like that. He needs to be told that what he is. And that's why Jambavan tells Hanuma, among the apsarasas best is Punjakasthali. And Punjakasthali, because of a shapam, she was born to Kunjara and as Anjana Devi. And once when the Vayudeva was breezing, he found her beautiful, and because of the desire for him, for the Vayudeva towards Anjana, you are born. That's why you are Anjaneya, because you are son of Anjana. You are Maruth's son, so you are Maruti. Vayudeva promised to her that the son born to me will have the powers, the strength, the energy, the vigor, the valor, the vibration that the Vayu has. So you have all those things. As soon as you are born, you thought Surya is a fruit and you want to swallow it. And because of that, Indra, with his Vajrayudham, hit you on the cheek. Cheek is, in Sanskritam, is Hanu. Hanuman, because of that. So you are called Hanuman. So as son of Vayu, you are the only person capable of crossing these 100 yojanams. A yojanam in Sanskrit is 8 miles. Now you don't try to calculate whether India is Sri Lanka's 800 miles. Because we are talking of a Treta Yuga and we are in Kali Yuga. As all the monkeys were praising Hanuman, he was told that he is the only person capable of crossing these 800 miles. He mentally already went to Sri Lanka, that's what Valmiki says. Sa vegavan vega samahitatma haripravirah paravirahantah manasamadhaya mahanubhavah jagamalankam manasa manasvi jagamalankam manasa manasvi. Manasoda yarkana poitangla. He went away already, he was there in Sri Lanka. So, from there the Sundara Kanda begins. Sundara Kanda is a very important component of Ramayana. People who don't read Ramayana also do the parayana of Sundara Kanda. Sundara Kanda by itself is a parayana grantham. Ramayana has 6 cantos. The one which describes the balyam is Balakanda. One which describes the incidents in and around Ayodhya is called Ayodhya Kanda. The Kanda that deals with the incidents of Aranyam is called Aranya Kanda. That deals with Kishkinda is Kishkinda Kanda. That deals with Yuddha, the last Kanda, is Yuddha Kanda. But this particular one is called Sundara Kanda. Now there are several interpretations, commentaries, why this is Sundara Kanda. This could have been Anuma Kanda or Sita Kanda or Lanka Kanda or Anveshana Kanda or whatever. It's not that. So, we see in Sundara Kanda there are 3 aspects. One is crossing the ocean. Samudra Taranam is one. The second one is Lanka Gamanam, going to Lanka. The third one is Sita Anveshan. These are the 3 aspects of Sundara Kanda in a nutshell. Now, Ramayanam is a Mahakavyam. First, we should understand there is a difference between an itihasa and a kavyam. In Sanskrit literature, only Mahabharatam is itihasa. Ramayanam is not a itihasa. Ramayanam is an epic, but it is a work of poetry. It is kavyam. Kavyam means one which is done by a kavi. So, the components of a kavyam, a poetic work, should be there. That means there should be shabdam, there should be ardham, there should be rasam and bhavam. So, anda vagayal pata, we will find that Sundara Kandam will have shabda saundaryam, ardha saundaryam, and rasabhava saundaryam. Shabda saundaryamana, there should be some pleasing shabda saundaryam where, ardha saundaryam where. If there is beauty in the meaning, it is ardha saundaryam. There is beauty in the very words, vocabulary itself, that is shabda saundaryam. We have lot of examples, particularly in Sundara Kanda, in the first canto itself. Valmiki describes moon 3 times. Every time he describes moon, he describes in a different way. For example, he says, moon is like a hamsa in the sky. Hamsovajada rajata panjarastaha, simhovajada mandara kandarastaha, and the moon looks like a lion inside a cave. Viroyadha garvita kunjarastaha, as if a very valiant man who defeats an elephant sits on the elephant. Andamadri irkana, moon. Chandropi babhraja tadambarastaha. Babhraja. Bhraja means shining. Babhraja means brilliantly shining. He was there. So that kind of vocabulary, shabda saundaryam, you can see. And in ardha saundaryam, there are plenty of descriptions. And there are upamas and utprekshas, the figures of speech and so many things like that. For example, when Hanuma takes off, it's a very beautiful figure of speech. When Hanuma takes off from this mountain, the cliff, he has made such a impact and force and pressure on the other surroundings that along with him, some trees have been uprooted and went along with him. And he says the trees which went along with him are like relatives who see of another relative. Urthar yara veetukku vandu, when he was about to leave, we make sure that he has gone. So we go up to the gate or up to the railway station, up to the train moves and see that he goes. So Andamadri, you see that with Hanuma, all these trees, the small stones and trees have also moved along with him for the force and velocity with which he left. And he gives two examples there, like relatives who follow a relative, like army which follows a king. Your king madri munadi poittirundar, pinadi these people have been going. Andha madri oru artha saundaryam. Adhe madri, there are several kinds of rasas, all the navarasas you find. Or edathula vandu he says, when Hanuma went inside the Ravana's mandiram, he finds dim lights during the night. In the dim lights, look at this, what a kind of simile from a person like Valmiki. He says, these dim lights look like gamblers who lost in gambling. And they were looking at the same as if they are, you know, dull but looking, not able to leave the place. Andha madri iruka. So, dhurtavi mahar dhurtaihi devanena parajitam. He talks about gamblers unable to leave the gambling den. Andha madri examples ella. So, you find ardha saundaryam, chabda saundaryam and rasa bhava. All the nine rasas you find in only Sundara Kanda. In other kandas you may find one or two. But all the Navarasas are found in here. So that way there are three Saundaryams. From the point of view of a poetic work, there is a Shabda Saundaryam, there is an Artha Saundaryam, there is a Rasa and Bhava Saundaryam. Then you come to the characters. In this only, you find Hanuma is described from the first canto. There are 68 cantos in Sundara Kanda. 68 you find Hanuman from 1 to 68. His beauty is described. Now, Sundara means not beauty actually, not the external beauty. It is the pleasing personality trait of any person. Some people may be very handsome, very beautiful to look at, but you know, they don't speak. Their face may be a wooden face. You cannot help. There are some people, they may not be very pleasant to look at, they may not be very beautiful to look at, but they are pleasant to, you know, talk with, conversation with. So, pleasantness is beauty. That Sundaram Pata, Hanuman is the most Navavyakarana Panditaha. He knows nine different kinds of Vyakaranas, that he does not use any word, any letter, without connotation. So, the Ramayana, the Sundara Kanda describes Hanuma's beauty in all the 68 cantos. And from the 15th canto you find Sita and all her beauty. How she beautifully described the wonderful descriptions of Sita. And then in the last few cantos you find Rama. And also Sita describes Rama to me. Because she doubts whether this person is Ravana in disguise, because the Rakshasas are capable of changing their shapes and sizes, Kamarupas. So she thinks that this man might be Ravana in the form of a monkey and trying to entice me and talk to me. So let me find out what he thinks about Rama. And he describes Rama fully. So you find the Saundaryam of Rama, Saundaryam of Sita, Saundaryam of Hanuman. So from characters, if you look at it, you find the three. And if you look at it spiritually, you find Paramatma as Rama, Jivatma as Sita, and Acharya as Hanuman. One who tries to remove, dispel your doubts and make you again inclined towards God is Acharya. Acharya is one who acharati, because he practices what he preaches. Guru does not need to. That's why we have a lot of gurus and very few acharyas. So this acharya, you find Bhagavat Saundaryam, Jiva Saundaryam and Acharya Saundaryam. In the Madhuri Patha, there will be nine different kinds of Saundaryams in the Sundara Kanda. Shabda Saundaryam, Ardha Saundaryam, Rasabhava Saundaryam. Sita Saundaryam, Hanuma Saundaryam, Rama Saundaryam. Bhagavat Saundaryam, Jiva Saundaryam, Acharya Saundaryam. From nine different angles, you find beauty all over. That is why this is called Sundara Kanda. Sundara Kanda is also full of mantra shastra. In fact, We say there are 24,000 verses in Ramayana. Charitam Raghunadasya Shatakoti Pravistaram Ekaikam Aksharam Praktam Mahapatakanasana. Shatakoti means 100 crores. Now that is reduced and given to us in 24,000. 24,000 reflect the 24 letters in the Gayatri Mantra. And in this you have the 12th letter, Va. Tatsavitur Varenyam Margo Devasya Dhimahi. That Va is there. Now you may say, Ta is there, Sa is there, and La. No, you cannot find your chosen letters here. There is a specified way of calculating which letter of the Gayatri Mantra is embedded in where. And that is given to us by the our preceptors and ancestors. So, idhula vandu 12th letter irukum. Central part of the 24 letters. Adhanal also it works like a pivot. Where, you know, the Gayatri Mantra revolves around. That is why also this is Sundara Kanda. Now, there are very many ways of chanting Sundara Kanda. Sundara Kanda Parayanam is one of the most easiest and wonderful things to give you peace of mind. And how do you do it? There are 100 ways of doing it. There are people who do one canto a day for 68 days and do it 7 times. That means 476 days. That is one way of doing. Andalavukku nam ellarkum time kadikade. Because we have time for other things, not for spiritualism. So then for people who do not have time, there is one abridged version, I'll tell you a little later. But people who have time can do it this way. And every time you do a Sundara Kanda Parayanam, you should also deal with Sri Rama Jananam, Sita Kalyanam. You should also see that Rama Pattabhishekam is also chanted. At least, whether you worship or not, all devotees are interested in the prasada. So the prasada vinayamavadu pannanam. Then there are people who will do it in a particular mathematical way which makes it 16 days. First day 2, 4, 4, 4, 3 days. Then you do 8, 1, 8, 1, then 5, 5, 7, 6, 1, 6, 2, 4. That's how this meant for 16 days. 16 naal la indha parayanam pannala. Oru naal layum pannala. 68 naalum pannala. 476 days pannala. 365 naalum pannala. It all depends on what you want to do. So, Rama Pattabhishekam and Mangalam are compulsory. Now, we now start Sundara Kanda. This is all the introduction of Sundara Kanda. Before we start Sundara Kanda, we need to do at least a little bit of Ramayanam before that. So, instead of going through all that, we will just describe the 16 characteristics of Sri Rama. 16 Lakshanangal, because he is called Chandra. Chandra has 16 colors, 16 phases. So, in the 16 characteristics are given in one shlokam that Valmiki asked Narada in the very beginning. Konvasmin sampratan loke gunavan kachya viryavan dharmagnyachya kritagnyachya satyavakyo dhadavrataha charitrena cha koyuktaha sarvabhuteshu koyuktaha vidvan kasamardhachya kachyaika priyadarshinaha atmavan ko jitakrodho jitiman ko anasuyakaha kashya bibhyati devascha jatarosascha sayuge. These are the 16 characters. We don't need to go through the description and you know details of those. We have already learnt about it, and even listening to the shloka is good. All of us don't understand Vedas, but listening to Vedas will give us a vibration. And the madri in the 16 gunangal oru vaati parayanam pannikitte we'll now get into Sundara Kanda. Sundara Kandam, as I said, has 68 cantos. The first canto, the first loka, is the most abridged version of Sundara Kanda. People who cannot read Sundara Kanda Parayanam for 68 days, 476 days, 16 days, can just read one shloka, the first shloka itself. Because the ancestors, they have, from the very beginning, the quality of a wonderful poet, the quality of a great devotee, the quality of the density of a spiritual personality is reflected in the very first verse. The first verse, every time, you take whether Kalidasa or you take Bhavabhuti or you take any other Dandi or any other poet or even Valmiki, you take, the first verse always reveals the entire story embedded in the entire book. So, adhanala, in the shloka mattum, tato ravananitayaha sitayaha chatrukarchanaha yesha padam anveshtum charane charite pathi. This is the shloka. Very beautiful shloka. The shloka itself will evolve, you know, if you just read this one shloka itself, it dispels, it destroys, and it gives you, destroys sins and negative feelings in you and makes you a positive person. Tato ravananitayaha sitayaha shatrukarchanaha yesha padamanveshtum charana charite pathi. In the one shloka or rendu moonu shlokanga mattum, we need to know the word to word meaning. Because this shloka, when we say it embeds everything, envelops everything, what is that it envelops? We need to understand. This shloka, as I said, gives the 12th letter of the Gayatri Mantra. That way it is important. And whenever any chanting begins with Tataha, it is considered pure and pious. Those of you who know Aditya Hridayam know Tato Yuddha Parishrantham. It begins with Tato. Tato Yuddha Parishrantham Samare Chinta Yastitam Ravanan Jagrato Drishto Ayuddhaya Sampagamit. So that is the Tataha itself is then. Then, Tataha means then. Tataha Ravananitayaha. Very simple shloka. As I said, all of you know Sanskrit. Then, Ravana Nitayaha, taken away by Ravana, Sitayaha. Sita, who was taken away by Ravana. Shatrukarshanaha. One who weakens, he does not destroy them, he has no mandate now to kill Ravana or defeat Ravana. He can only weaken Ravana. That's why this entire story is said in this shloka, because it says Hanuma goes to weaken Ravana. He goes, he kills half of them, he destroys the buildings. One monkey, if it can do so many things, if he is coming with millions and billions of monkeys, what will happen to the Lanka? And he destroys his morale, he destroys his strength, he destroys his confidence. So Shatrukarshanaha, one who weakens the enemy, Iyesha means he determined, he decided. Padam anveshtum means to search. Padam means the location. Actually, padam means location, but here the padam is a very spiritual word. Vaikuntha padam, guru padam, and the madri padam andra word e oru punidamana word. Padam anveshtum charana charite pathi. He took the path. Pathi means path. Sanskrit and English are very close languages. P-A-T-H, I is pathi. P-A-T-H is path. He took the path of charana charite pathi. That is taken by the celestial singers. That is one thing. Another thing is rishis and saints and preceptors who have all taken the route to achieve salvation. That is the route that he has taken. So, Acharya is Shatrukarshana. This shloka gives two meanings. One, that Hanuman has taken off towards, in search of locating Sita, and he has taken off in the path that is taken by the celestial beings. This is the normal physical meaning. This also talks about Acharya. Hanuma is an Acharya here. So what is the Acharyatvam? Acharya also destroys your enemies. Shatrukarchana. He weakens your enemies. Who is the Shatru in us? Bhagavad Gita tells us. Chapter 3, Karma Yoga, 43rd verse, talks about who is our Shatru. The only Shatru who cannot be caught. Very difficult to catch, very difficult to control, very difficult to defeat. Kamam. Desire. Now this kamam is such a wonderful word. This is there in purusharthas. Dharma, artha, kama and moksha. For a purusha, these are the four things, that four goals that you need to achieve. You have to be dharmam, you have to artham, you have to follow dharma, you have to achieve artha, you have to also achieve kama, and then you get moksha. Purusharthas la inda kama solli, kama enemy ansolra. What is this? That is the reason why the Upanishads tell us, dharma and moksha are on the two sides. Dharma, look at the order, dharma, artha, kama and moksha. Dharma and moksha are two sides, and in between there is artham and kama. So you cannot violate dharma, you cannot violate moksha when you are following artham and kama. So kamam jahi shatrum mahabaho kamarupam durasadam, says Krishna Bhagavan in sloka 43 in Karma Yoga. If you can defeat, if you can control, if you can put kamam under control, then you will win everything. Durasadam, it is not easy to, it is not impossible, but it is difficult. Control. So what are the, you know, we have, all of us are pro, nobody wants to wantonly do bad things. Nobody wants to do wantonly evil things. For that minute you think you justify what you are doing as good. That is the problem. The problem is intelligence. The intelligence makes you think, rationalize, justify what you do and say, why not? So there are three obstacles that we have. One, you think I am independent. Two, you think that I can protect myself, or there are friends and relatives who can protect me. Three, the most dangerous, you think that I can use God for my selfish purposes. I want this, I will have a bargain with him. Now, not on the seven hills, I will walk up and come. Yanaki idu pannina adu pannuva. 1,000 coconuts I will break if this happens. So these are the three points of ignorance that we have. One, you think you are independent. Two, you think that you can protect yourself, or somebody can always protect you, not the God, somebody. And then you can use, manipulate God. All of us advertently, inadvertently manipulate God, every day in and out. Pooja pandrama, innikku mudiyadhu, manipulation of God. 10 nimisham pannalama, 5 nimisham panna vendi, 1 nimishathula pannalama, manipulate the God. Prasada naivedyam pannalama, vaalapalam, we don't need to make payasam. Oru vaalapalam inda thol appadi koncham open panni, idhu da. Indha maadhiri we manipulate God. So that is why Guru Acharya removes these three. He tells us that you belong to God. He also tells us only God will protect you. And he also tells us whatever you do, do for him. Don't do for you and ask him to manipulate, try to manipulate him for you, but you do for him. That is why this Acharya, in this sloka, he said, Yesha, he determines, he decides, padam anveshtum. Now, who is Ravana? Ravana is a very beautiful etymology of the word. Ravayati asat pralapan karayati iti Ravana. One who takes pride and selfishness. There are two things, ahankaram and mamakaram. A combination of these two is Ravana. So in all of us there is a Ravana. And the Acharya will remove Chatrukarshana. He will weaken that Chatru. This Ravana, what is ahankaram, what is mamakaram? I is ahankaram, mine is mamakaram. That's all. Acharya Charane Charite Padi, he will go in the process of the path that taken by earlier gurus, earlier acharyas, in dispelling the doubts of the sishyas. So this shlokam, tato ravana nitayah sitayah shatrukarchanah yesha padamanveshtum charana charite padhi. This shlokam is the most wonderful shlokam. This is the only shloka. If you cannot read all the Sundara Kanda Parayanam, just read this shloka, just every day once. Not many letters, 32 letters. So read that. Now, Hanuman is described, that is why Valmiki, in this particular Sundara Kanda, not anywhere else, not in Kishkindha Kanda, but here, and not even in Yuddha Kanda, he talks about him, he uses some adjectives, he uses adjectives like sadhaka, jnani, acharya, mahapurusha, duta. These are the characteristics of them. Now, another word that Valmiki uses in this particular chapter, in this Sundara Kanda, is duskaram, impossible. And Hanuma is one who can make impossible possible. That is why manojavam maruta tulya vegam jitendriyam buddhimatam varishtam vatatmajam vanarayodha mukhyam siramadutam sirasanama manojavam. Avaroda speed vandu of the speed of the mind. He thought he is already in Lanka, and the madri manojavam maruta tulya vegam, and his speed is also the speed of the wind god. So, duskaram nishpratidvandam chikirsha karmavanaraha samudagra shiragrivo gavampatriva bhavam. This is the second shloka. I am not going by shloka to shloka, don't bother, don't worry. What I am going to tell you is, this particular shloka tells us how a yogi, you know, this is Hanuman going, crossing 100 yojanas is a yoga, is a sadhana. And for that he was initiated. And he also tells, very clearly he tells later on, that he goes like the arrow from the bow of Rama. Rama vitta oru baanam madri na poyittu vandranga. He does not think he is going. That is the beauty. So, in fact, surprisingly, all words that we come across, there are 4 or 5 words that we use for monkey in Sanskritam. Kapi, Vanara, Shakhamrugam, Harihi. In the 4 words, they all indicate in another way, every word indicates an Acharya, a Guru. Adhanala, Gavampatihi, an inner word. He was looking like a bull. A monkey is looking like a bull under Valmiki. When he was about to go, about to take off from the cliff of the mountain, how he was looking, he kept his head up, neck up, he turned towards the south, and he was about to leave. He looks like a bull. Only the bull will keep its neck up. So that is what he says. And Gavampati also means mantra rajam. Or one of the mantras, or 10 mantra irukkumba, adhula periya mantra edirukkumba, adhu Gavampati. Gavampati ana Gavamanna mantra. Appadiyen solrar. Hanuma started. How did he start? What did he do? Namma endha vela pannalum, there is a process of doing things. Chumma eppadi venalum appadi panna koodadhu. So what he did, Hanuma did, he turns toward east first and saluted his father. Then he turned towards south and started moving. First is east because sandhyavandanam. Sandhyavandanam panname. எதுவுமே பண்ண முடியாது பண்ணக்கூடாதுன்னு சாஸ்திரம் சொல்கிறது. நம்ம சந்தியாவந்தனன்னா என்னன்னு கேட்போம். சில பேருக்கு வந்து பூனலன்னா என்னன்னு ஒரு பிரச்சனை இருக்குது. அது எதுக்கு போடணும்னு இன்னொரு பிரச்சனை இருக்குது. இப்போ என்ன எதுக்கு இது இது வென் யூ பிகம் மோர் அண்ட் மோர் இன்டெலிஜென்ட் யூ ட்ரை டு ஆர்கியூ டெஃபினெட்லி ப்ளீஸ் ஆர்கியூ பட் பிஃபோர் யூ ஆர்கியூ வாட் யூ நீட் டு டூ இஸ் ரீட் தி புக்ஸ் அண்ட் தென் ஆர்கியூ. யூ டோன்ட் ரீட் anything about anything and you think you are authority on that and start arguing. That is the problem. Now here what he does is, he was on the cliff of the mountain, he looked at east, saluted to his father, turned towards south because that is the direction he is going to take, and he pressed through the cliff. Before you jump, you press it. When he pressed it, what happened? He says, some smaller stones started falling from the mountain. And all the flowers and the trees of the mountains have started falling on the mountain, and the mountain looked like a mountain of flowers. And then, for this, the animals in the mountain caves were all agitated because there is something happening that never happened earlier. So, the animals in the cave started making noise. And then he tells, before he leaves, just before he takes off, he tells all the monkeys around, Yadha Raghava Vinirmuktaha Sharaha Shashana Vikramaha Raghavanodaya Banam Madri, I am leaving now. Gachet Tadvat Gamishyami Lankam Ravana Palitam. From here, like an arrow, I go and go directly to Lankam Ravana Palitam. Ravana Paripalan Panditanda Lanka I will reach. And then Nahidrakshyami Editam Lankayam Janakatmajam. If I don't find Sita there, from there, Anayenaivahi Vegena Gamishyami Suralayam. With the same speed, I will go to the heavens. Svargalokambara. There I will search for her. Because we don't know, Ravana may be the king of Lanka. But because you have abducted somebody, you don't keep that person publicly somewhere. He might have hidden her somewhere else. So, ulagamellam paathittu varuvan. Then if I don't find, I will take away physically the Lanka along with Ravana and bring it to Rama. That's what he says. Lanka toda, Ravana roda. I will bring all the Lanka physically and place it in front of Rama's feet. This is what I want to do. He tells them, and where he does not say, I am going, I am doing. Rama Banam Madri Poran. That is Karma Yoga. When you think you are doing, you will not do anything. When you think somebody is there to do, then you are doing, you are an instrument. Even Hanuma thinks he is an instrument. He does not think he is the source. He is not the doer. The doer and the done is somebody else. That particular jnanam is jnanam required for an acharya. Then he did yoga abhyasam. Valmiki very, very beautifully describes that he has narrowed his waist with purakam, kumbhakam, rechakam, and moon steps, pranayamala. With one you take the breath in, that is purakam. You hold it, that is kumbhakam. You leave it, that is rechakam. He took the breath in with kumbhakam, and then what does purakam, kumbhakam, rechakam do to you? The Shastra says, Patanjali Yoga Sutra says, that all of us are a combination of three qualities. Tamoganam, Rajoganam and Sattvaganam. Tamoganam is ignorance is bliss. You find, you eat, you sleep. When you are awake, you fight. This is Tamoganam. Rajoganam is, I can do everything. There is passion, there is an ahankar. That is Rajoganam. Sattvaganam is you don't find that you are anything. You depend on God for everything. And the Sattvaganam. In the moonume namakulla irukku. In the when you do the kumbhakam, purakam, kumbhakam and rechikam, that cleanses you of the Rajoguna and Tamoguna and makes your Sattvaguna more predominant within you. All of us have this combination, but that combination makes it the more concentrated Sattvaguna at that time. So like a karma yogi, he leaves. While he left, as I said, all the like the relatives, the trees went along with him. The stones went along with him. And as Valmiki said, they look like relatives or they look like army following a king. Now, he was going. He's already started. At a little later, what happens is, Samudram, he is crossing the ocean. Samudram is another pair of Sagaram. Sagaram is another pair of there is a king in Ikshvaku dynasty, very earlier to Rama, known as Sagara. The Sagara performed an Ashwamedha Yagam. And Ashwamedha Yagathil enna pannuvom, they will worship a horse and leave it. Wherever it goes, the people there should accept the sovereignty of the king who sent this horse, or they should fight with him. Now this horse is missing. Horse evlo dooram pona avlo dooram varudha. Horse is missing. Where is the horse? So the Sagara Putras, there are 60,000 sons for Sagara. And they could not locate the horse anywhere, so they started digging the entire earth. They dug it so much that the place which was dug by them has filled with water, and that is called Sagaram. Sagaranoda nala vandadunala adhuk Sagaram nu per. So Sagara thought, this Hanuman is going on Ikshvaku dynasty, another king's work. The mission is Ramachandra's mission. Ramachandra belongs to Sagara's dynasty. So I need to give him hospitality. He is crossing. So how can I give him hospitality? He asks Mainaka. There is a parvatam inside Samudram called as Mainaka. At one point of time, the story goes that all mountains used to have wings. They used to fly everywhere from one place to another place. It is a very, very cumbersome thing, you know. It's dangerous if mountains and buildings start flying. So what Indra did, Indra tried to remove all the wings by destroying the wings with his Vajrayudha. At that time, Mainaka was thrown into the Samudram with the help of Vayu, father of Hanuma. Look at this connection. So the connection is that Vayu helped Mainaka to save his wings and hide himself in the ocean. And ocean is Sagara because of Sagara. So because of two double gratitude, gratitude of Mainaka, gratitude of Sagara. They said, Sagara asked Mainaka, please raise up to the water level, above the water level, and stay here so that Hanuman can rest here for a while, eat some fruits and roots, and then take off from here. After all, what is important is kartavyam akrutam karyam satam manyamudirayet. Periyavanga edavachona na panna matan sollakudada adava nam pannitirukom. So Valmiki says in chapter 197 sloka in Sundara Kandam, you should not disobey the orders of elders. So Sagara asked Mainaka, please do this. Mainaka did not want to disobey. Also, Kruteche Pratikartavyam Yasha Dharma Sanatana. Sanatana Dharma Yandra Chalrade Pratikartavyam. If anybody helps you, try to reciprocate. Bhartrihari says there are four different kinds of people in the society. Four different kinds of people. People who are very good, Uttama kind of people, they will forget doing their work and do others' work. This is Uttama kind. There are second variety, they do their work and also others' work. They are Madhyama kind. There is a third variety, they will destroy others' work for doing their work. There is a fourth variety. They will see that neither you do your work nor I do my work. In the four varieties, Irkan Sulrar. But what Sanatana Dharma says is Kritagnyata. Dharmagnyascha, Kritagnyascha, Satya Vakyo, Dhradavrataha. Abdin Padanar Gunangal Ramar Sulumbad Kritagnyata or quality. Now Kritecha Pratikattavimesha Dharma Sanatana says Valmiki in 1.1.14. Then Atidhi, Atidhi anna ponavattichonna, Tidhi illame varuva. He will not tell you on this day, this time I will come. Shulli varuvangala Atidhi illa. Chollama varuvanda Atidhi. Avarikku vandu, when he comes, chulli irukka koodada, na idu pannirupen solla koodadu. You should give him the food that he likes. So, Atidhihi kila pujarha prakrutopi vijanata. See, Valmiki, while telling the story, gives us some morals here and there. Vijanopi, even if you don't know a person, prakrutopi, even if he looks uncivilized, atidhi is pujarhaha. You have to worship him. So, adhanala, let Mainaka, you please raise above the water level and let request Hanuma to stop for a while and then let him take rest and then move on. Let him eat some fruits. Give him some breeze. After all, why is sun? So Mainaka saluted Hanuman and told, please rest here. Your father helped me. All other mountains have lost their wings because of Indra. I keep still my wings. So it is because of your father's help. So please rest here. You are going on Ikshvaku's mission and Sagara asked me to help you. You know what Hanuma said? Pratignyacha maya datta. I have made a vow. Na statavya mihantare. And I should not stop on the way. Like a Rama's arrow means Rama's arrow does not stop at one place and then eat something and go somewhere else. That is why I will not. He said that. And then he touched Mainaka very affectionately and left. Now the gods wanted to see whether this Hanuma is very sincere. Whether this Hanuma is very sincere, what is his sincerity? How much commitment he has? So they have asked a Surasa. Surasa. Nalla pair. This is a divine damsel, an Apsarasa, who is come here as in a Shapam. They have asked her, you try to stop Hanuma. So she made her mouth very big. The entire space is filled with her mouth. And he said, Hanuma, you are my food, please enter me, I will eat. He said, let me increase my body, you also increase your mouth, let us see. So Hanuman also grew in proportion, Surasa also moved her mouth in proportion. Then suddenly he became small, entered her mouth and came out. And said, you asked me to enter your mouth, I have entered your mouth, I finished my job. Thank you very much. Namaskaram. I am going on Ramakaryam. Please leave me. And Surasa blesses him and tells him to go. Now, as he goes, there is another Rakshasi by name Simhika. Sugriva tells Hanuman at a different context, he tells him, the Simhika is a very different kind of a Rakshasi. She has wonderful powers. What is her power? She can pull anybody by pulling the shadow. She does not pull you. She will pull the shadow and you will come along with. So Simhika is Chaya Grahini. Chaya means shadow. She absorbs, she pulls the Chaya. She started seeing Hanuman flying because when you fly, and Valmiki describes, in the morning time when you are flying, your shadow will be too long. So periya ivlo iruke, so this fellow will be a good food for me, breakfast. So she tries to pull and Hanuma realizes and enters into her mouth and tears her with his nails, kills her and comes out and enters Sri Lanka. Lanka he goes. Lanka when he enters, Hanuma, we have four different things here. Now a sadhaka, there are four steps that he does. One is dhruti, another is drishti, third is mati, and the last one is dakshyam. These are the four steps he crosses. While doing a work, do not be enticed by any sweet words. That is dhruti. Mainaka tried to stop him, he did not get enticed by it. The second one is drishti. Control of senses. You have to be in control because somebody is trying to ask you to come into the mouth. And that is the time when you need to know why you are going, what is the purpose on which you are going. And your purpose is more important than your prana. So that goal-mindedness is called drishti. The third one is also the same thing, mati, with the Simhika, and Dakshyam, he comes to Lanka. When he reached Lanka, he reduced his size so small that nobody recognizes him. Nobody can see him. That is the size he reduced to, because as he was flying, for the sake of crossing the ocean, he raised his body, he improved his physical personality to gigantic size. Now he wanted to reduce his size and enter Lanka. There is a Trikuta Parvatan there, outside Lanka, not inside Lanka, just at the beginning of the Lanka. He stood on that and had an aerial view of Lanka. Look at this kind of Hanuma. He tries to look at what is the army they have, how many people, how many roads, how many horses, how many elephants. He was trying to look at everything that is possible from there. How many buildings are there? What is the security arrangements for each of these buildings? He was looking from there. He was also looking at how beautiful this city is. Hanuma looks at Lanka and he realizes, first thing he tells us, even if all our monkeys army come here, what can we do? Can we reach this Lanka at all? Even if we reach, can we defeat this possible, you know, this huge force? There are a lot of rakshasas there. He describes rakshasas with one eye, with two noses, with five ears and things like that. So different kinds and shapes of rakshasas are there. So much of army is there. Even if Rama comes, even Rama I don't think can win this. He thought for a while, because Hanuma is after all a monkey. Monkey's character is basically chanchalyam, inconsistency and fluctuation. So for a while he thought so, and then he realized, who, if at all, if we all come, who can enter Lanka? There are only four people who can enter Lanka among us. One is Vayuputra, myself. Another, Suryaputra, Sugriva. The third one, Angada. Angada is Vali's son. He can enter. The fourth one is Agni's son, Neela. Neela, Angada, Sugriva, Hanuma. Only these four can enter the Lanka city. Nobody can even enter Lanka city. What will we do when we come here? He thought for a while. And then he thought, as a duta, the first quality of a messenger is not to spoil the task. Whether you achieve it or not, that is a different thing. Don't spoil the purpose for which you have come. So, he wanted to be very careful. So what he did is, then again we will find another description of moon. One problem for Hanuma is, he wanted to wait until it is night. Now the Rakshasas are known as Nishacharas. Their day begins at night. Now these people are awake during the night, but they are intoxicated, so they will also fall asleep. So he wanted to enter in the night, during the night. Yanisha sarvabhutanam tasyam jagatti sanyami. Bhagavad Gita Sankhya Yoga chapter 269 shloka tells us that when everybody else sleeps, yogi is awake. A yogi's mind is awake. When we sleep, even if opens the doors and takes away everything, some people don't get up at all. Some people get up even for small sounds. A yogi is one whose mind and atma are awake at the time when everybody else. Yanisha sarvabhutanam tasyam jagrati sanyami yasyam jagrati bhutani sanisha pashyato muneh. That is the shloka in chapter 269, Sankhya Yoga, which tells us that Hanuma is a yogi again. So then, he became, now look at the description of Valmiki. He became the size of a cat and entered Lanka. Why did he use cat? Are there no smaller animals than cat? Are there no big cats? Now the cat is because cat can see clearly in the night. That is why he uses the word cat. Vrishadamshaka matraha, matraha san bhabhuva adbhuta darshanaha. And then he started getting in. Hanuma approached, and when he saw the main entrance door, it is Vajra Vaidhurya Nilaghomedika Pushyaraga Marakata Manimaya, completely studded with all different kinds of gems. And he was about to enter, there is one lady in front of him. Who are you? Why did you come here? Kahaktvam Kena Karyeneha Prapto Vanalaya Vanalaya. Vaname vidu. Kaadu vida irukkaravan, monkey. Vanalaya. Why did you come here? He says, I want to see your beautiful Lanka and go away. Just one minute. I'll just go and see and come back, he said. She tries to talk to him, and before that he asks, if you ask me who I am, please tell me who you are. And Lankini says, I am aham rakshasa rajascha ravanascha mahatmanah ajna pratikshaye durdharsha rakshami nagari imam. I am the protector of this entire Lanka nagara. And she uses one more sentence. Aham hi nagari Lanka. I am myself Lanka. You can't get in without defeating me. And so saying, with a palm she hits Hanuma. Hanuma looks at her. You are a woman. I don't retaliate strongly. I'll give you a mild hit. So he gives her a mild hit. With that mild hit she falls down. She falls down and then tells him, once upon a time, Brahma told me. He told me that whenever a monkey comes and defeats you, that is the first day of the destruction of Lanka. So I realize that you have come here for that purpose. I realize that bringing Sita, Ravana has committed a mistake. From the time Sita has come here, there are only bad omens. So now you are welcome to go inside and do whatever you want to do. And then Valmiki tells us that Hanuma does not go through the entrance main gate. She opened the door and asked him to go. And Advarena Mahabahu Prakaram Abhipuplave. Advarena, not through the dwaram. A means no. Dwaram, not through the dwaram, but he Abhipuplava. He jumped over the Prakaram. And there he uses, this is what is meant by great poets. He can say Anuman, he can say Maruti, he can say Vayuputra, something. He says Mahabahuhu. He has big shoulders. Because of the strength in his shoulders, he jumps across the Prakaram and gets into Lanka at once. As Hanuma gets into the vicinity of Ravana Mandiram, Valmiki again describes moon. There are three times I told you, this is the third time he describes. Now Sundara Kandam gives us three components. One is Anveshana, searching for Sita. Then Darshanam of Sita. The third one is Virodhi Nirasanam. He will not go back without weakening the enemies. So three things on the mission that he came is to search for Sita, to locate Sita, to weaken the enemy and go back. So these things, Anveshana is the first thing. Every time we use this word, he will not use any other word, because Anveshana is a word that is normally used in Upanishads for so Anveshtavyaha. When you talk about ultimate reality, your concept, your mission of reading an Upanishad is to locate the ultimate reality. Anveshtavyaha, Anveshana, these are the words he uses. Then we find Hanuma entering the Ravana's Antapuram. He goes through the cities, the roads and cities. He finds that it is like Alakapuri. Alakapuri is the Puram of Indra. There is A in front of it, otherwise it's Lankapuri. This is Lankapuri. He also thinks that this is equal to Vaikuntham and Kailas. Such beautifully built. And so, here, again, where Valmiki describes when he jumps the Prakaram as Mahabahu, here as he enters Ravana's Antapuram, he calls him Asasadada Lakshmi Ivan Rakshasendra Niveshanam. Lakshmi Ivan, Abden Soldar. Hanuman Lakshmi Ivan, why does he need to do that? Because Lakshmi and Aishwaryam are two things. Aishwaryam is wealth, richness. It is not money. Aishwaryam is Ishwarasya Bhavam. Yadi Ishwaran Kurtana, the Elame Aishwaryam. Adikada, you know, people who wear this vibhuti, vibhuti means that viseshena bhuti gives brilliance. Aishwaryam Kodukaravan Hanuman Abdin Sulra. Adana, to look at Lanka from outside, Lanka is equated as body, Sita is Atma. And Ravana is Manas who tries to manipulate Atma. This is Acharya and there is Paramatma there. He wants to restore Atma back to Jivatma, back to Paramatma. So that's why Lanka is body. So he can see Lanka from outside, he can go into Lanka without being afflicted, he can also see Sita later on, he can come back without being anyway inundated by the circumstances around him. So because of that he calls him Aishwaryavan. And then he goes to see different things. Hanuman's mission is not just finding Sita. He also wants to know what is the strength of Ravana. So he sees Virupaksha's house, he sees Prahastha's house, Indrajit's house, Vibhishana's house, Kumbhakarna's house, Mahodara, Virupaksha, Vidyujiha, Vidyunmali, Vajradamstra, Indrajit, who are all the important people, how their buildings are protected, how much army is there, he was looking at that. And finally, he enters Antapura. With that, we will stop here today. Because from here, his search for Sita begins. He has crossed the 100 yojanas and came to Lanka. So we will stop it today. We will kayena vacha manasendriyarva buddhyatmana va prakte svabhavat karomi yad saklam barasme narayane iti samarpayami. Yadaksharapadabhrashtam matra hinanti yadbhavet tatsarun shamyatan deva narayana namastate. Mangalam kwasalendraya mahaniya gunatmane chakravarti tanujaya sarvamaya mangalam. Sarvamangala mangalye shive sarvartha sadake sharanye trembake gauri narayana namastate. Sri Akkantaya Kalyana Nidhiye Nidhiyardhinam Sri Venkata Nivasaya Sri Nivasaya Mangalam Mangalashasana Padayi Madachari Purogamai Sarvaiccha Purvaira Acharya Satkrutaya Mangalam Sasti Prajabhya Paripalayantam Nyayena Margena Mahim Mahishah Gobrahmane Vyasomasti Nityan Lokasamasta Sukhino Bhavantu Kale Varshat Parjanya Pradhivi Sashyashalini Desho Yang Shavarita Brahmana Santa Nirbhayaha Aputra putrinas santa putrinas santa putrinas hadanas sadanas santa jivanti sardam shatam sarvam sri krishna arpanamastha.